Hare Krishna. Satisfaction comes by knowing ourselves, not by making ourselves known. We all want to be satisfied, to be happy in life. And especially we feel that if we become famous, we become well known. If we enter into a room and everybody turns to observe us, to smile at us, to appreciate us, if we become a celebrity, then we will think we'll become happy. However, making ourselves known in itself doesn't make us happy. Many people who become celebrities, later they strive for anonymity because they can't have any privacy at all. So, along with that, even if we make ourselves known, whatever recognition and glorification that people may do, that is short-lived. And along with that, nothing comes free in the world. Along with fame comes infamy. Along with glorification comes criticism. And most importantly, you could say, the craving to be glorified, to be recognized and glorified, is like a fire that never ceases. And thus, we gain not satisfaction, we get titillation, but we stay perpetually dissatisfied when we seek satisfaction by making ourselves known. More realistic and relishable way to seek satisfaction is by knowing ourselves. What do we mean by knowing ourselves? It means that we recognize that there are many layers to our being. We are not just our physical shells. We are not just our fickle minds. We are at our core indestructible spiritual beings. And we are parts of an all-attractive whole. When we understand ourselves, that means we understand ourselves spiritually as well as materially. We understand who we are and we understand what kind of body and mind we have. Then we can learn to live in harmony with ourselves. And when we understand that we are parts of the Supreme, then we learn to live in harmony with that Divine through working with the resources that we have, the body and the mind, in a mood of service and contribution. When we thus know ourselves, that means we work in harmony with our physical, our material nature to realize our spiritual nature as parts of the all-attractive Supreme. Therein, we relish the supreme satisfaction of life. The Bhagavad-Gita states in the third chapter, in the sixth chapter rather, that sukhamatyantikam yattad buddhi grahayamati indriyam. In 6.20-23, the Bhagavad-Gita speaks and it says that yatro paramate chittam niruddham yoga sevaya yatra chaivatmanatmanam pashyannatmani tushyate. So it says yatra chaiva atmanatmanam, that herein, yatra, in that state, chaiva atmanatmanam, we look within, we know ourselves, pashyan atmani tushyate, we see ourselves and we delight in ourselves because we understand our own spirituality, our own potential beauty as the part of the supremely beautiful being. And thus, we can relish the supreme satisfaction. So this doesn't mean that we don't at all seek to be known by the world, but that we do so that we can enhance our service and our contribution. We don't depend on that for our satisfaction. Rather, when we get inner satisfaction, that is the satisfaction which lasts forever. Thank you. Hare Krishna.